Good morning, Vandal. Today we are going to continue with that regularization techniques. When coming to L1 regularization, that will try to remove unnecessary features. Removing unnecessary feature means it will try to make sum of the weights to be zero. When coming to L2 regularization, that will try to reduce the magnitude of weights. That may not make the weights to be zero, but L1 regularization will try to make sum of the weights to be zero. That's the benefit we are going to get with L1 regularization. We are going to get sparse solution for those weight vectors. Most of the weights will become like zeros. Those weights correspond to almost irrelevant features or less relevant to our classification or regression problem. For example, consider some error surface. This is two dimensional. We are having W1 and W2. These are two parameters here, and loss is function of these two parameters, L of W1 comma W2. Loss is function of these two parameters. We have two parameters in our model, W1 comma W2. This is L of W1 comma W2. This y coordinate. This coordinate corresponds to loss. These two coordinates corresponds to weights, W1 and W2. For example, this is 0, 5 and 10. This is 0, 5 and 10 for W2. This is for W1. And this corresponds to loss, this axis, like x coordinate, y coordinate and z coordinate. And there is some coloring, right? You can try to see this red color corresponds to high loss region, high loss. And this color corresponds to little bit less loss compared to this one, but still this is high loss only. And this is low loss region. The loss function value is very, very low in this blue colored region. And these are the contours. Here you can see some circles or some ellipse kind of thing, right? What we are doing here is we are trying to cut this 3D shape horizontally. We are trying to cut this. If you are trying to cut that one, along that cut, loss value is constant, right? For example, for L of W1 comma W2, we are going to cut at 15. Loss function value 15. If we try to cut this shape at 15, then we are going to get some circle or some ellipse at this point. It means that on top of that circle or on top of that ellipse, you are going to get constant loss function value, right? For those parameters, for those weights on top of the circle, you can see some certain weights, right? W1 comma W2 coordinates on top of this circle. For all those weight values or parameter values, you are going to get constant loss function. Loss is constant. And when you look into this figure, this red colored ellipse outside is having very high amount of loss, and almost everyone is having same loss on top of this ellipse. This is having little bit low loss compared to this, further less, and so on. And when I come to this circle, inner circle, this is having very low loss as compared to these. And all points on top of this circle are having same amount of loss. That's what this is representing. 2D contours. Let's have a look into L1 regularization and L2 regularization. Before going to that one, let's have a look into the second term in our regularization. We are defining the loss as follows, right? Lambda W1 comma W2 equals to some mean square error loss, if that is regression. If that is classification, this might be some cross entropy loss, this one. Plus some penalty for the weights, right? For example, if that is L2 regularization, then this will be W1 square plus W2 square. If that is L1 regularization, then our loss function will be as follows. Mean square error plus lambda into W1 mod W1 plus mod W2. For example, consider lambda equals to 0.1. So just lambda should be some positive constant. If I increase my lambda, the penalty also increasing for the weights. If I decrease my lambda, penalty for the weights is decreasing. If I increase it, penalty for the weights is increasing. Like this we can consider. Let's try to have a look into this term first. This term and this term. If I consider that L2 regularization, the penalty term is lambda into W1 square plus W2 square, right? Let's consider this is W1 and this is W2 coordinate and this is 0. This corresponds to W1 square plus W2 square equals to, this is circle, right? Equals to 1. And this corresponds to W1 square plus W2 square equals to 2. Because this is a circle, right? W1 square plus x square plus y square equals to a square. Corresponds to circle with a center 0 comma 0 and radius a. See 1, this is 2. And if I go for this, if this is 4, then this corresponds to W1 square plus W2 square equals to 4. On top of this circle, the sum of these two things will be 4. Like that we can see, right? As this circle keeps on increasing further and further, this radius, this W1 square plus W2 square value also keeps on increasing, right? This is also increasing as you increase the radius of this one. Similarly, let's have a look into L1 term. That penalty term we are having is some lambda into mod W1 plus mod W2, right? It's a penalty term we are having. And if you try to plot that, this is 0, this corresponds to W1, this corresponds to W2 axis, and now this corresponds to mod W1 plus mod W2 equals to 1. Mod W1 plus mod W2 equals to 1. This contour. Kind of rhombus, right? Or diamond shape. And this corresponds to here this is 1. This value for W2 is 1. See minus 1. See minus 1. And this corresponds to 2. Mod W1 plus mod W2 equals to 2. This is 2, 0. 0, 2. This is 0, minus 2. This is minus 2, comma 0. And if I go further and further, this contour corresponds to mod W1 plus mod W2 equals to 4, for example. Then this will be 4 comma 0 comma 4. This is 4 comma 0. And this is 0 comma minus 4. See minus 4 comma 0. lambda into some term in the right, that term I am trying to plot. Like this we can expect. Now let's have a look into that once. L2 regularization. With loss function as follows. With this kind of loss function, let me look into this. I'll try to construct this kind of loss function. Here, loss function is giving minimum value at 5 comma 5, right? You can see this. At this point, minimum, right? 5 comma 5. At 5 comma 5, W1 equal to 5, W2 equals to 5. You are going to get a minimum value. As you go far away from this, like a circles, the loss function value keeps on increasing and constant on top of a circle. Up to that you can see, right? I am trying to plot that loss function. This is W1, loss function contours. This is W2. This is W1 equals to 5. For example, this is W2 equals to 5. At this point, we are going to get minimum loss, right? 5 comma 5 point. And as you go further and further, as you go further and further, what's happening is losses keeps on increasing. As you go further and further, this losses keeps on increasing. It's loss value. And this is becoming like red. Red means danger. We are having high loss, right? Just imagine like circles. The loss keeps on increasing further and further. And the loss is constant on top of this circle and low. And bit higher loss. And constant on top of this circle. And little bit higher on top of this circle. And constant on the circle. Little bit higher, it's a very high loss. Like that you can think. If you go with lambda equal to 0, that means there is no penalty at all for your weights. Then if you apply gradient descent algorithm, you are going to end up with this solution, W1 equal to 5 and W2 equals to 5, because we are trying to minimize that loss without penalty, right? If there is some penalty, what you are going to get is, if there is some penalty, for example, L2 regularization. Let's consider lambda equals to 0.1. It means penalty we are going to get is 0.1 into, just for example, consider lambda equal to 1, just for simplicity. Then the penalty we are going to get is the second term, 1 into W1 square plus W2 square, lambda into non W2 square, lambda equal to 1, and N2 lambda means W1 square plus W2 square. This gets smashed W1 square plus W2 square equals to, for example, this gets smashed to equals to 1, and this gets smashed to 2, W1 square by W2 square equals to 2, like that. And this corresponds to some 3. And let's have a look into this. This corresponds to, here the circles. Can you imagine what can be this value? It's a radius, right? W1 square plus W2 square equals to radius square. It's a circle, right? Here the radius corresponds to 5 root 2. 5 root 2 whole square. 25 into 2, 50. This corresponds to W1 square plus W2 square equals 50. With L2 regularization, what we are doing is, we are trying to minimize sum of this function and this function together, right? Sum of these two functions together. We are trying to minimize both together. We don't want to minimize only this part. Now try to see what's happening. Here at the circle is increasing. In this case, if the circle radius is increasing, its penalty also increasing. Here, if the circle is increasing, the loss is increasing. That first term is increasing. Mean square error loss function part is increasing. Here, if you increase this circle, that penalty is increasing. You want to minimize both together, right? For example, I want to focus on low mean square error region. At this point, you can see the penalty, right? Penalty is very, very high. Penalty you are going to get is lambda into 50. Lambda equal to 1, right? Lambda into non W squared. Here non W squared is 50. 1 into 50. You are going to get huge penalty for you, right? Then the sum will be higher because the second term is high. Even though first term is almost negligible, it's mean square error, second term is so high. Then what we need to do is we need to reduce the weights. If you try to reduce the weights, for example, after reducing the weights, you got some circle like this. For example, this corresponds to 25. Let's say W1 square by W2 square equals 25. But the error you are, mean square error you are going to get is a bit high compared to that, right? Earlier you got almost nearby zero. Now the mean square error you are going to get is somewhat high. Let's say, for example, 5. Mean square error you are going to get is 5 here. 5 plus 25. Penalty plus error, right? 5 plus 25 is 30. 30 is the total error you are getting. Earlier case you got roughly, if I consider mean square error for this is 0.1, for example, for this least point, plus penalty is 50, right? It means I am getting 50.1. 50.1 is higher compared to 30, right? It means this is preferable solution compared to this one. This is preferable, right? It means my solution is good at this point as compared to this point. But at this point, if I consider only that first term, mean square error term, that is 5, here 0.1. That mean square error is high compared to this one, right? You can think it like overfitting. Here you are trying to do overfit, almost by hiding along with noise, so that your training error is almost zero. You are memorizing training data, almost zero. Here you are not by hiding the things. This you can think something like perfect fit at this point. Let's say if you try to reduce this circle further, for example, this penalty part, for example, this is 20. And mean square error corresponds to this one. This is a mean square error. This much is the mean square error. Let's consider mean square error to be 15 instead of 5. This time that is 15. And total error you are going to get is 35, right? 35 is higher compared to 30. So that you can try to finalize like this. Try to finalize these weights, W1 and the constant W2. As your final solution to your model, that learning model. Like that you can do. Instead of lambda equal to 1, if I try to increase my penalty, for example, if I try to make it like 100, lambda equal to 100, then what I am going to get is, just with W1 square plus W2 square equals to 1 circle itself, my loss function contributed by penalty is 100. 100 into W1 square plus W2 square. This is the second term in your loss, right? That penalty term. 100 is the penalty just with this one. Now my error is so high. You can see mean square error is so high, right? I am extending this circle further and further. This is the intersection I am getting. Let's assume that my error in this case is 35. Mean square error. Total error I am going to get is, total loss I am going to get is 135. This 135 is still higher, right? I'll try to reduce this further and further. Because this penalty term is so high. Because lambda is so high. If I try to make this like 0.001, for example, the W1 step and W2 step equal to 0.01, then my penalty will be in 200. In 200 means 0.1. And the error I am going to get is roughly, for example, 40. That means whether this is 40.1, right? This is less compared to this total. I may try to fix this one. It means if you try to apply more penalty to the weights, then your finalized weights you are going to get are very less, right? They are nearer to zero. Those weights you are going to get are nearer to zero. If you apply more penalty, when lambda is so high, when lambda is less, you may get some reasonably high weight values or some moderate values, right? Weight far away from this zero. That's the beauty of regularization, that lets you simplify your model. And here you can try to see the weights you are going to get are somewhere along this, right? These are the possible weights you are going to get based on your lambda value, based on your penalty. None of them became like completely zero. None of these weights, W1, W2. But both of them trying to become like zero, but none of them became like zero, right? They are non-zero. They are trying to decrease their magnitude of those weights, W1, W2. That's what they had done till now. Instead of this, if you go with L1 regularization, what's going to happen with L1 regularization is, let's consider this corresponds to 5,5 point W1, W2. This part corresponds to mean square error loss, that first term in your loss expression. The mean square error keeps on increasing, like that you can think. And this is our L1 loss. Norm mod W1 plus mod W2. Let me try to write it clearly. I had some mistake in plotting this. This corresponds to, let's say, this is 1. Mod W1 plus mod W2 equals to 1. Mod W1 plus mod W2 equals to 2. Mod W1 plus mod W2 equals to 3. For example, just for my convenience. And let's assume that, similar to earlier, lambda equal to 1, for example. And at this point, my mean square error loss is 0.1. And on top of this circle, my loss is 0.8, and on top of this circle my loss is for example 2, on top of this circle my loss is 4, like this. This is a mean square error loss, that first term, and this corresponds to penalty term. If I consider lambda equals to 1, then what's happening is, if you want to go with this kind of less loss, I need to intersect this one with this, right? I need to find where I am going to intersect that one. Yeah, you can try to visualize this one similar to that L2 regularization. You can try to compare with it. Here, we are going to get a solution as a sparse solution, right? You can see, at this intersection, at this intersection, is W1 is 0. No, not W1, W2 is 0, right? And W1 is some positive quantity. We are going to get sparse solution. One of the parameter became like 0, right? This advantage of L1 norm regularization as compared to L2 norm regularization. You can try to look into this. If you keeps on increasing that mean square error part, if you keeps on increasing that part, if you go outside and outside, and if you try to look into this penalty term, it's a penalty, right? W1 square plus W2 square. They are trying to intersect at this point. This is the optimal point where W1 is very low and W2 also a bit low, but none of them are zero. And you can try to see this. In this case, both are intersecting at this point, where this point corresponds to, at this point W1 is zero and W2 is some positive quantity, right? That means one of the parameter became like zero. One of the parameter became like zero means some of the features nullified in your model. For particular feature where W1 weight is there, the W1 weight is becoming like zero. That means you completely remove that feature because that is irrelevant feature. That's what you have done, right? Indirectly. That means with the help of L1 regularization, you can try to remove or avoid irrelevant features with the help of L1 regularization. And again, you can have a look into these figures. You are going to end up with sparse solutions with the help of L1 regularization as compared with L2 regularization. And L is stopping concept. This x coordinate corresponds to number of epochs or number of training iterations. Number of iterations of your, for example, gradient descent algorithm during training process. As the number of iterations are keeps on increasing, the training error, this black color line, the training error keeps on decreasing further and further. But what happens to validation error or test error is that it keeps on decreasing up to some point. After that is increasing. The reason for this one is I started with some complex model. My model is so complex so that I consider up to higher order feature terms. If I train it deeper and deeper, if I try to increase the number of iterations, what will happen is that I'll simply try to by heart noise along with signal in your training data. In the initial stages, in general, they will try to lengthen the major pattern of your signal, because signal component will be dominating as compared to noise in most of the data sets. As you train deeper and deeper, that means during initial stages, they will try to track that signal almost during initial stages of training up to some few iterations. After that iteration, after so many iterations, what happens is it start tracking along with noise. Even though noise is less dominant in your as compared to signal, that's minute variations also will be tracked with the help of this high complex model if you train further and further. That's the problem you are going to get. With more number of epochs, this will try to simply by heart that entire training data, including noise. That's what you are seeing in this graph. Up to some number of iteration, that's fine. This validation error also keeps on decreasing because it's trying to lengthen that signal pattern. After some time, they'll try to capture, they'll try to track noise also after some number of iterations. That's why this validation error is increasing. It's some sort of overfitting at this point. Is almost like right fit. Here it's almost like under fit. During the initial stages, only some of the components will have reasonable weights. At this point, almost all the useful components will have reasonable weights. Almost all the useful features will have reasonable weights. At this point, irrelevant features also will try to have some weight. Like that, you can think in other way. Here, you need to stop your training. Once your validation error is low and started increasing after that, you can try to stop here and you can fix these weights. Fix the weights that you learned up to these iterations. Thank you.